in part one, we used the Picasso library, not so much improvement. In part two, we put the loading of images in an async task, not so much improvement either. What's the old saying? Strike three and you're out. Welcome to Mobile Application Tutorials. My name's Nigel. In part three, we're going to be using the inScale factor size, inScale size provided to us by the Bitmap Factory. So what we want to do is we want to load a lot smaller image into the bitmap and apply that to the image view. Loading smaller files, smaller bitmaps, less RAM, less process overhead, and let's see if that improves the performance. And I've also used this technique in this previous tutorial as well. So this for optimization, so well recommended to use this technique. So we'll make a start. Go into your bitmap worker task, and we're going to create a couple more variables to represent our desired width and height of the image view. And I think I'll call this one called target. It's important we put width on the end. Oops. So I've hard-coded these two values to represent our desired width and height of our actual image views. That's what we want them to be. Okay, next step here is I'm going to create an algorithm that's going to work out the difference between my image view, desired image view width and height, to the actual photo dimensions width and height. And that scale I want it to be a factor of 2. Purely the scale I'm going to work out is going to be fed into the bitmap factory inSample size. Just to take a lot of, and that functionality provided will load a lot smaller image into the bitmap. Okay, so first thing is algorithm, work out the scale factor of 2. So okay, it's going to return an int to represent our scale factor. That's, what should we call it, calculate. Let's call it inSample size. Now this is going to take what we call the Bitmap Factory bitmap options, which are going to contain the photo width and the photo height. So pass a bitmap factory options. I'll call it BM options. Okay, so I'm going to create two variables here, which will be the photo width and the photo height, and I get that from the bitmap factory options argument. That's the out width variable that will give us that. We'll do the same again for height. Now I'm going to add one more variable, and that's going to be actually contain our scale factor. So it's going to represent scale factor of 2, the difference between photo size and final image view size. And we make that 1 for the moment. That's the default size. So if there's no differences in size, the scale factor will be 1. So it will load the full image into the bitmap. Okay, the next step here is we want to check to see if the photo width and height is actually larger than our desired image view dimensions. And this will be our target image view width here. Or we do the same thing for the height. So if it is bigger, then we start doing some further calculations to work out the actual scale 2 difference. The first thing that we need to do, we're going to drop down the photo width and photo height by a scale of 2. Create new variables for that to represent that. Let's call it half photo width. And we'll do the same thing for the height. Okay, with the half photo width and the photo height, we're going to check that against the desired width with the calculation of the scale factor. So we'll put that in a while loop. What we want to do is keep reducing the half photo width and half photo height until it reaches, it gets close to the desired image view width and height, and then we'll send that scale back. We'll return that scale back. Okay, anyway, this is algorithm stuff, and a confession from me, I'm not really a big person, big on algorithms myself, but okay, so half. So we divide that by a scale factor, and then see if it's bigger than the target width. And we'll do the same for the height. By scale factor, bigger than, I'll just put a little space between that so it's easier to see. It's bigger than target view height. So if it is, we increase our scale factor variable by a factor of 2 and then go back in there until the half width and half height comes close or reaches below the desired width and height, and then we return that scale. Notice that the half photo, the actual width and photo will always be larger than the desired output because we have divided it by half, but that, you know, we need to keep it that way. Okay, so scale factor, increase it by scale factor 2. And that's it, and then we need to return that scale factor. Okay, this is, so we've now calculated our scale factor to the closest factor of 2. Okay, next thing we're going to do is the decode. We're going to decode the file itself with the scale factor. So we'll create a function to do that. This one's going to return the bitmap. Let's call it decode. This is bitmap from file. This is going to take a file. Let's call it image file. Okay, the first thing we want to do is the calculate inSampleSize function took the bitmap factory object. We need to create that object here. Options, it's called bitmap options. And create that new object. That's now created. Now we're going to set a flag here so we can do a dummy file read on the file without actually loading the bitmap. So to do that, we can set this flag here in just code, and we set that to true. So I just want to do a dummy read of the file but not actually load the bitmap. That's what that does. Now we're actually going to load the file. Well, not, we're going to do a dummy load of the file so we can get the photo width and height. So to do that, that's just how we'd normally do it. With the image file, and we have to pass the path to that with the bitmap options. And this is going to populate the bitmap options object with the photo width and height. So now with that information, we can now send that to calculate inSampleSize to get our scale factor. And the result of that will load into another member inside the bitmap options. And this member is called inSampleSize. So we can set that, and we just have to call our calculate with the BM options. Okay. So now the bitmap factory options now holds the actual scale factor, which represents the distance, the difference between the original photo and the image view widths and heights. And it's calculated that to a scale factor of 2, which is what this variable wants, is what works with scale differences of a factor of 2. Okay, now we can actually load the bitmap itself with what we'd expect to see a reduced bitmap size. So before we have to do that, we have to set the just to false. We actually have to load the actual bitmap itself, not do a dummy read. Right, now we can load the bitmap. And we're just going to return that result of that. Let's return, and again it's bitmap factory decode file image file, the path of the image file, and we pass it the bitmap factory option, which now has the inSampleSize, and we just need to delete this void here that shouldn't have been there because we're returning a bitmap. Okay, so inSampleSize is done to work out scale factor. We've now going through the process of sampling the original source image to get the width and the height, feeding that into a sampling size, which will allow us to load a reduced size bitmap. So now we go back into the background task where we're executing the code. We can comment out this line. And now we can return the function we just created before, decode bitmap. and the file is params, just like the function we commented out up there. And that's it. I must be asleep this morning. I've put a few voids in my return functions. So we've now corrected both our functions. So let's try running this code and see what happens. The application's now started. I'm going to record what we're seeing on the screen. Okay, this is looking promising. Application hasn't crashed, and you can probably see. There it is there. Now let's scroll. Okay, wow. Big difference. Something basic only load the actual file, only load the bitmap that matches your required image views. Makes a huge difference here. We'll take a few more photos, just a couple more. I'm doing this on an old Nexus 4 as well, so it's not like I'm doing this on the latest phone, which has a lot faster hardware. Let's take one more of the computer. And let's do some scrolling. As you can see, we're getting a lot faster. Notice those two images change at the top. I'll do that again, see if you pick it up. And just scroll to the top. See those changes? That's our concurrency problem, which we'll talk about in the next tutorial. Anyway, that worked. We got a marketable performance improvement on our scrolling up and down. So definitely, this made a dramatic improvement. And remember, put these sort of optimizations on a background task, on a background thread, using something like an async task. Okay, I'm actually happy with that. We'll see if June's happy with that at a later stage. Stop recording. Okay, I'll just shut down this. As with the general flow of these tutorials, we're just going to put some debug in the code and step through the changes we made. And in this case, I'm interested in my photo image view and height. And I'm also interested in see what scale factor is calculated. Let's move this cable out of the way. Okay. I'm going to put one in the, just down here to see what scale factor we get. And this will also show me the photo width and height. And we'll put one down here as well. And so I'm not going to put one in here. It's pretty self-explanatory. We're calling the function that we method that we created. Okay, let's debug that. So straight away, because we're a gallery reloading images, straight away our scale factor calculation is going to start happening. So from here, we're creating our bitmap object. I'll just go press go. Now here's where I really want to see what's happening. Down here, we've got the photo width and height. You can see 2,448 pixels. 3,264 pixels. It's a bit too big to have in a little thumbnail. You don't need it that big. So, and scale factor of 16. So basically, it's a huge difference between our desired, what we actually want, to what actually has been giving us when we originally loaded. So we're putting a scale factor let's carry on stepping through the code now. So we're now providing a scale factor of 16 just to reduce that our images, you know. So the actual image is going to be by a factor of 16, by a scale factor of 16 less than what we originally wanted it. And then we feed that back into the inSample size I've used for the bitmap factory. We do a real read this time, and then we load the bitmap with the inSample size scale factor, and we return that back. So let me just remove these two breakpoints and carry on running it. And this is going to be slow because it's debug. There's a lot more mapping code to be executed, but it's still, even though this is a debug build, you can see this is still way faster than the previous one, running on old Nexus 4 hardware as well. So this has definitely given us what we would want for a performance improvement. Okay, so that's it for this performance improvement. We've still got one more problem, concurrency problem. We'll address that later. Okay, from this tutorial, we learned that by working out the scale difference between your origin dimensions, such as the photo width and height, to the destination of what you actually want, in this case, the image view width and height dimensions, does make a significant difference. We had to do a bit of algorithm code to work out that scale factor, and then basically read in the dimensions of the original file, put in the scale factor after that, and then load a lot smaller bitmap and return that to our image gallery. And that made a significant change. Okay, that's it for this one. If you like my tutorials, subscribe. That's all for this one. Bye for now. Okay, again, we've got the image view, which is a good sign the application hasn't crashed. Let's scroll up. Now, it's a bit slower. That means we're discarding bitmaps. Okay, I'm not seeing any of the concurrency effects before that we were seeing before.